Hello folks, as we mentioned on our last video that we like to keep you updated with the auto world. Well, to stick to those words, we are right now back with another video, and this time is the new Hyundai Verna. Well, when the car was launched, according to Hyundai, they received around 15,000 bookings. That's a great number, and this just shows us how popular the car really is amongst the audience. So on this episode of Fortune Reviews, we are going to find out why that is. So without any further ado, let's dive right into it. Before we commence any further, I would like to thank my Hyundai Kolhapur for lending us this car. They are the main reason that the review was possible. See the Verna passing by on the road and there is a chance that you will mistake it for the new Elantra. Well, yes, there is very much difference in the design and there is also very much size difference. But as the basic design remains the same, you can mistake it for the Elantra. And like the Elantra, the new Verna styling conforms to Hyundai's sculpture 2.0 design language. So the look isn't as flamboyant as the last gen Verna, but this is a handsome car nonetheless. Swept back headlamps and the bumper with chrome surround for the fog lamps add distinction to the front. You won't find any glitzy cuts or creases on the side of this one, rather luxury comes in the form of chrome door handles and chrome piping at the window line. The rear bumper that is shaped to aid airflow is bulky and even makes the top spec Verna smart 16-inch alloy wheels appear smaller than they actually are. Last gen to current gen, the Verna has grown 65mm in length and also sits on a 30mm longer wheelbase. Interestingly, the new Verna is identical in length and wheelbase to the Honda City. Now let's talk about the boot capacity of the car. The boot is 480 liters and it is pretty adequate for those highway and airport transfers, but the loading lift, according to me, is a bit too high and that could have been improved. Now let's get inside the car and find out how the interior is. Now the quality in the new Verna has been improved drastically and this becomes obvious the moment you close the doors. The old Verna's hollow sound on door shut has made way for a reassuring and even European car-like thunk. Those behind the wheel will find the cabin a neat and user-friendly place to be in. The low sill of the dash allows a good view out. The center console is usefully angled, if ever so slightly, towards the driver. The infotainment system is placed high up and within easy reach, and all the buttons and controls are logically positioned too. The whole look and the feel of the dash is properly Hyundai. It's just that while the dash is smart and quality is consistently good, perhaps use of soft touch plastics on the dash would have helped to take the Verna's cabin to the next level. You sit reasonably low in the Verna, but thankfully the driver's seat height adjustment moves the entire seat. The front seats are shapely and well finished but aren't the largest around, and some may also find cushioning a bit soft in the lower back region. Now talking about the engine, the 1.6 litre petrol and diesel engines have been carried forward from the previous generation Verna. Now I don't need to tell you about the refinement levels that Hyundai offers. So the already good engines have now been retuned to give you even better performance, and the torque and the power figures do see a bit of a revision here. The dual variable valve timing equipped petrol engine for one makes the same 123 horsepower as before, but now it does so at 6400 rpm rather than the earlier Verna's 6300 rpm, and where the engine developed its 155 Nm of torque at 4200 rpm in the old Verna, it makes a marginally lesser 151 Nm at a latter of 4850 rpm in the new car. Hyundai has also enhanced the engine's low-end pulling power to ease drivability. At 1500 rpm, the engine now makes 130 Nm of torque as opposed to the 121 Nm in the older car. If you happen to be a high mileage user, it's the diesel Verna that will be of greater interest to you. The 1.6 litre variable geometry turbo diesel continues to top the segment for power with 128 horsepower, and the torque here is 260 Nm. The crucial difference here is that the torque is now available at 1500 rpm to 3000 rpm band, as opposed to the narrower 1900 rpm to 2750 rpm in the last Verna. In the ride and handling department, this gen Verna is a leap forward than the previous gen Verna, which was very soggy and very unsure on the highways, On twisty roads, you will like the grip that the Verna has to offer. So here on the rear seat of the new Verna, the support and the cushioning has been improved, but the lower sitting position is far from ideal. Also, in terms of height, if you are above average, you will find a bit problem. My height for reference is 6'1", and the headroom for me is more than adequate. Now, talking about comfort, there are some C-segment sedans that do offer more comfort than the rear seat of this Verna, let alone the City and the CS that have much more comfort and much more space on offer. Regarding the most important factor, that is safety, it is taken care by 6 airbags on this top trim, and ABS is standard across all the variants. So that's it for the new Verna, guys, and I hope you liked the video. The car is a full package and it just lacks in terms of the rear passenger headroom. If you are looking for a car in the C segment, you should definitely opt for it. This is the video for now, and I hope you liked it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. This is Fortune Review signing off. Thank you.